Security in Bukoman Simbi has recovered 58.8 million shillings from Paris Development Model officials in the district in an operation led by Jorin Kalisa Chomokama, the Deputy National Director for the model. Kalisa ordered the arrest of Dr. George William Sekanoachi, the PDM coordinator in Bukoman Simbi, Alex Mabirizi, the focal person, Teddy Nakagera, the Kagologolo model chief, Harriet Nankabira, Esako's chairperson, and Juko Godfrey, Esako's insurance money collector. This followed an outcry of SACO members accusing them of extorting 160,000 shillings from each beneficiary. According to SACO members, the officials deducted 50,000 shillings for insurance, 100,000 shillings for the parish chief, and 10,000 shillings for the chairperson. After recovering this money, officials called all the victims to receive their money, a gesture that pleased many of the SACO members.
Chinuchizibiti, chinuchiraga, nti esente. Eza insurance zebali baja ku bantu aba beneficiaries ba parish development modo tuzinunude
na saba akakadde ne bampe mitwala 5 ana 8 bangamba anti bakuwadde
form wajichusa
Super.
Kalisa, however, said that there's still more work to be done in recovering more money that were extorted by the officials. She then urged police to continue pursuing the matter.
To me, I thank God that we are taking this money, that we still have some money to recover. The DC, the DPC, together with the DCOCI, and the whole team. We still have money to recover. We are not yet at 100%. Because we still need that 15,000 and the 10,000.
The arrest of the official marked a significant step in the fight against corruption in local government programs, emphasizing the need for accountability and transparency. The hearing of a corruption case against three members of parliament, Yusuf Mutembuli of Bunyola East, Paul Akamba of Busiki County, and Sisi Namuju, Luengo District Woman MP, resumed today with the testimony of Mariam Wangadia, the chairperson of Uganda Human Rights Commission. Presided over by Justice Lawrence Jijuri of the Anti-Corruption Court Division, Wangadia revealed that most of the conversations between her and the suspects were in Luganda, requiring translation before proceeding with the case.
I confirmed that what we had listened to was what had transpired in the meeting. And I was able to identify my voice and the voices of all the three accused persons.
Court, however, declined to hear Wangadia's testimony in the audio recordings bearing the conversation between her and the accused legislators.
We are still at examination in chief.
Again, as we stated in our earlier objection, the state wishes to play the voice. From where? We have not yet read that background.
The court also directed her to conclude her testimony today and added that she would be contacted later if needed. Defense lawyers asked the court for time to interact with the accused persons before they could cross-examine Wangadia.
The data you still have to the burden of adding weight to it, so that the court can rely on it, otherwise it remains floating on the record.
Justice Jidudu said he would like to expedite this case in the interest of both parties. He therefore adjourned the case to the 14th of July to allow them ample time to gather more evidence. Kenyan police fired volleys of tear gas today in the heart of the capital, Nairobi, as small groups of protesters gathered on what was billed as fresh day of action against embattled President William Ruto.
Someone, you! We don't give a fuck.
Riot police patrolled the streets of the central business district and roadblocks were set up on the major arteries. Many shops were shut, but only a few dozen protesters turned out chanting, "We are peaceful." The East African nation, one of the most stable in the region, has been rocked by weeks of sometimes deadly protest against Ruto's two-year-old administration, mostly led by the young Gen Z Kenyans. While Ruto was overseeing the swearing-in of a revamped cabinet just a few kilometers away, police lobbed tear gas in the central business district and detained several people. But otherwise, the streets appeared largely quiet, with a few people going about their normal businesses. Stevens Wanjiku, a 29-year-old fashion stylist, said she has taken to the streets since the demonstrations began in mid-June to demand good governance and accountability.
I have been out on every protest, and I wish even this protest started earlier, because we've really suffered as a country. We have some problems we could really cure as a country, but we're not taking steps to cure that, because those that are supposed to transform this country are part of the problem.
Kenya's acting police chief Gilbert Masengeli had warned yesterday that criminals intended to infiltrate the demonstrations and advised people to stay away from protected zones such as the main national airport and Ruto's official residence and take precautions in crowded areas.